The Latécoère 631, a massive 20-passenger flying boat from the 1930s, aimed for transatlantic travel. Due to its unreliability and high operating costs, 5 of the 11 produced were written off in accidents, while 1 was lost in World War II. What happened to the rest of the aircraft? Join us in this video as we transport you to France, where a similar colossal aircraft is taking shape. We delve into the captivating yet perilous world of the Latécoère 631, a plane that was as beautiful as it was deadly. Luxury flights to Europe were available on the Boeing 314 during the transatlantic aviation boom. In 1936, French civil aviation was looking for a 20-passenger flying boat with a 6,000-kilometer range. Potet, Lioré et Olivier, and Latécoère put their thinking caps on and began sketching out designs. Did they craft distinct designs, or did they share notable similarities? In fact, there were some striking similarities. Each had a hexameter configuration with 6 strong engines, and of course was enormous, with the Latécoère taking the crown for biggest. Competitors like the Sud-Est SE 200 Amphitrite and Potet Cam 161 developed. In 1936, Latécoère introduced their design, known as the Laté 630. Their goal was to create a 44-ton all-metal aircraft that would be powered by the formidable 6 Hispano-Suiza 12Y engines. Why did the Air Ministry decide to put a stop to Latécoère's work on the Laté 630 design? What changes did they ask for? They asked for a 40-passenger aircraft with a cruising speed of 300 kilometers per h and a 5,000 kilograms cargo capacity. Range remained unaffected because the Laté 630 already met expectations. Latécoère focused on speeding up and expanding the design. Significant alterations were made to the Latécoère 631, including the installation of Gnome Rhone 18P 1,500 horsepower engines. The Air Ministry favored Latécoère after this revision, and the Laté 631 design was finished. The Latécoère 631 and SE 200 were both works in progress when Germany invaded France in June 1940. What were the specific details regarding the SE 200 and Potez 161 aircraft? Unfortunately, those details remain unknown. Latécoère had to put the 631 construction on ice during the German invasion and shift gears towards military manufacturing, rolling up their sleeves for the war effort. The project got back on track in 1941, and by mid-1942, it was a wrap, 4 years down the road from its initial commencement. With a length of 43 meters, a spread of 57 meters, and 6 Wright R2600 Cyclone engines, it became the longest aircraft in history. It finally took to the skies in November 1942, with its setback cockpit and distinctive design. Sadly, the Laté 631 fell under German control. They claimed it as their own with their emblem and steered it to Lake Constance, nestled along the Swiss-German border. Fearing German theft, workers at the factory sabotaged the project rather than completing it, opting for disassembling it, hiding the parts, and destroying the factory. How did they manage to hide parts of the 631? Well, it remains a mystery. When Allied forces liberated the factory, they unearthed the hidden pieces and kicked off the final assembly of the aircraft. RAF Mosquitoes attacked the first Laté 631, and it was an American raid that put the nail in the coffin for sealing the project's fate. What significant improvements and advantages did the Laté 631 bring to transatlantic aviation? Latécoère persisted, and testing began again in March 1945 with the debut flight of the second prototype. 4 were ordered, and Air France used them to fly to the French West Indies across the Atlantic. With a top speed of 300 kilometers per h, the Laté 631 could travel from New York to the West Indies in 5.5 hours and across the Atlantic in 15 hours. A lounge, bar, private cabins, and an impressive 6,000-kilometer range. What a lavish and extravagant way to travel. It commenced passenger service with 3 French airlines. However, a catastrophic engine failure occurred, resulting in the propeller being sliced, and the outcome was truly tragic as it cost the lives of 2 passengers. This incident signaled the start of a string of mishaps that plagued the aircraft. Even though 2 lives were tragically lost, the subsequent ferry trip epitomized the tragedy with the loss of all 19 lives. A snowstorm worsened the already poor weather conditions, causing the aircraft to lose control. Despite the crew's brave efforts, the 631 couldn't withstand the elements. The crash claimed all 19 lives, and ice buildup on the control surfaces is likely to blame. The lack of a de-icing system gave rise to safety concerns regarding the aircraft's design. The Latécoère 631 faced a series of fatal crashes and safety concerns, leading to its retirement. Within a decade, it claimed the lives of 101 people due to various issues, tarnishing its initial image of soaring beauty with a tragic shadow that reached far and wide. Do you think the Latécoère 631 deserves its reputation as a beautiful yet deadly aircraft? Comment below.